Happy Thursday!
We are back in the saddle again. We had the fair, so and you were gone a week.
And it's been first a busy end of summer, so here we go.
Yeah.
We haven't had Melissa Jaeger from the Hyvee Savage in a long time.
Yes.
Welcome back.
Thank you. How have you guys been?
You know, we need your help because we just came back from the fair and we need a dietitian.
We need to recover a little bit, I think.
This is good because everybody is trying to get back into routine again.
Yes, exactly.
Summer's like chaos. It's right. Like, okay, wait a minute. Let's have some structure.
I know. Everybody's been busy traveling. There's been the state fair. There's been, you know, all of this getting ready for back to school. Now we're finally in it. So it's time to maybe start getting back on the horse and planning things again. And meal planning is one of those things that we all struggle with year round. Nobody is perfect. Not all dietitians are sitting there chopping their veggies every Sunday.
They're not?
I picture you doing so though.
Okay, it doesn't kill you to prep ahead, but at the same time, it's one of those things where it's not always gonna happen, but it'd be nice if you could get into a routine and a habit of starting it, or at least trying to have those ingredients available in your fridge so that when it comes time to actually, hey, I have a couple minutes, it doesn't take very long to get some of these items done.
And that is the single biggest thing. If you want to eat healthy, whether it's for your kid or yourself, like I always tell people, I'm like, you got to plan ahead.
You have to plan. And a lot of people are like, I refuse to plan. And I'm like, well, there are different options. There's vegetables and fruits that are already pre-chopped and available in stores, like our shortcuts.
And when you're hungry,
three times as much.
When you're hungry, you make bad choices.
So it is one of those things where if you can go in with a shopping list and a plan and say, hey, I found a couple recipes. We're going to try these this week. And it doesn't have to be a new meal every single night.
No.
Repurpose your leftovers, and those can get repurposed into different lunches as well. Or you can create some kind of new fun lunches to help your kids adjust to going back to school and saying, hey, we're
going
to eat healthier again, and we're going to get back into a routine.
No more freezy pops, kids. Summer's over.
And these are things, though, that your kids can help with. And it's all about, you know, treating them that food can be something that they can love as well. And it doesn't have to be you receive food as a reward. Food doesn't have to be, you know, a punishment
like
if you
dog.
Get lack of. You get to make and create fun different lunches that you can have together. So take a look. First off,
all right, what are we making?
The ladybug bento lunchbox today. So it's a ladybug in the garden.
I can see parents slightly. I mean, that's very cute and all, but busy parents. Like,
but here's the thing. Kids love cookie cutters, do they not? Will they not help you decorate sugar cookies?
That's true.
All you really need is a glass. You could use a jar, like a glass or jar, or you can use circular biscuit cookie cutters. A few dollars in the baking aisle at the store. You can get a whole set of 8 different sizes of circles, and all you really need is 2, one smaller, one larger.
And they don't like crust a lot of times.
That's
true. And so this is a...
Well, it wouldn't fit in the box, right?
Well, you could if you really pulled it in half and shoved it in.
Oh,
but why don't you go ahead and cut the base for our ladybug? So you're just gonna cut out the center of each part. And see, this is... Get the kids involved. Kids are more likely to eat whatever they are involved in making or preparing themselves at home. So once you cut that out, you got to use your muscles, Alicia. That's what I tell the kids in cooking classes.
I don't have any.
Use all of your muscles.
She can barely run 3 miles.
And then kids, half the time, if we cook it out, sometimes they go, can I just eat or snack on this? Sure.
Do you want to snack on this?
It's whole grain bread.
Whole grain.
You want whole grains within your diet. And part of what they're teaching children in school, not the food pyramid anymore. I don't know if you guys have seen my plate.
No, I haven't seen it.
But I brought an example today in the front. So my plate is kind of the condensed, easier version to understand for both adults and children to understand what your plate should look like at meals.
Wait a minute, though.
We all
grew up with the pyramid that had junk food on it, too.
It was a pyramid scheme.
Now you don't even have that on there, huh?
Because treats are still an okay thing, but we need to focus on what the main proportion of our plate is. Yeah. The main portion of your plate is not going to be that piece of chocolate cake that you have for dessert or that freeze pop that you have after dinner. That's not going to be your entire plate,
Sven. You seen the adult vodka freeze pop?
I have.
Side note.
That is not for school lunches.
No,
that is a
expensive.
Separate entity. Okay, but having half your plates as fruits and vegetables at all meals. So this is why sometimes those bento box lunch ideas help you break things down because not all children like their foods touching as well. So if you say, oh, you're going to have this fruit, you can put it in a separate little container. You can add your hummus and vegetables into a separate container.
Well,
you're eating the eyeballs right now.
They don't want the bread to be
doing?
Soggy.
Sorry. All right. Wait.
So then,
let's get back to our ladybug.
Yes. So then for our protein portion, or what would be a quarter of your plate, you're going to cut the turkey. So you can go ahead and you can cut the turkey.
Monitor things.
I will. I'll be on the lookout.
We welcome any questions along the way. But again, we're combining a whole grain. Now we're getting our protein, so you can put the turkey right in the middle there.
Okay.
And again, if your child loves mayo, mustard, you could mash avocado, you could put that on. Here's a spread. Some children like it plain. Don't like any sort of
spread.
What
about all this leftover?
Eat it. Roll it up. So one of the things that I did was I took some of the slices and I rolled them up and just put them in a separate container because that could be lunch for another day. You don't want to waste anything. Right. And it is easy to combine your protein and then have a little dairy with your sliced cheese there. And then all we need to do is cut one piece of cheese for the inside and then we'll add the wings in a minute.
Eat more of this turkey.
And so when you're going up to the deli counter, they always do have deli meat pre-sliced back there, but for today, I wanted to make sure that I was getting nice, even pieces that hadn't shredded. So you can always ask them to slice you fresh, whatever you would like, in whatever pound or amount you want. And with that being said, don't be afraid to ask them. Say, I only need a quarter of a pound of this. Can you fresh slice just a little bit of this? They're happy to do that for you. That's part of what they're there for. So if you're looking for those nice, even fresh slices, you can always do it that way.
Fresh slices.
All righty. Then we put it, they slice them fresh right away in the morning. They're not sitting out there for days at a time. Let's take a new slice of cheese, and we're going to use this to make our wings. So we're going to take the smaller size circle for this, if you want to cut that out.
I'm just eating here. Yep.
She's just snacking her way through meal prepping, which is okay.
When it's healthy.
Mm-hmm.
All right,
so here,
I'm struggling again. Oh, there you go.
Alicia.
I'm sorry.
You're stronger. I believe in you.
What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
So then for the wings, all we're going
to
do is
to live by.
Cut this in half. And you can place some like that.
And now, is this a ladybug or one of those Asian beetles that bite?
Ladybug, because we don't
want
to be
invasive. Ladybug sounds a lot nicer, doesn't it? Let's focus on the ladybug.
And they don't bite.
That's why Melissa doesn't like to visit
us. We're trying to be positive today, people. You eat my displays. What are you doing?
Steve says, if one apple a day keeps the doctor away, what will two apples a day do? Is this a joke?
That'll make you regular.
It will help your regularity, that is for sure. And honestly, most Americans are lacking fiber within their diet. So it is one of those things.
As well as children.
And you need to model those healthy eating practices for your children, because guess what? They're watching you every day. So if you're saying icky or yuck or gross to something at the table or refusing to buy it or refusing to prepare it, they're monitoring that. And they're at an age or a stage where they're more likely to copy exactly what you're doing or saying, even if they don't. So even, for example, when I'm cooking with kids at the store, I say that in class we have a rule that you can't say words like icky or yuck or that's gross or I don't want that in front of our friends and neighbors, because I always say you might hurt their feelings. And somebody next to you might love something that you don't. So we do a thumbs up or a thumbs down rating system, and they have to be quiet about it. So it keeps everything nonverbal, because a lot of times those verbal situations, they're looking around, they're trying to watch and see how other kids are reacting to it. So same thing goes for when you're prepping or preparing food at home. Don't be making faces. Don't be doing saying words that are negative
Unless
towards
you
the
cut
food.
Yourself.
Well, then you should probably
it's okay, kids.
Beep. You should probably go get a Band-Aid in and fix that.
No, it is, and you learn we've talked about this before, but you learn.
There goes your eyeballs.
My eyeballs went astray.
You learn your eating habits are gonna be with you for life.
They
younger.
Are, and
like it's the reason I crave junk food now is because we had it in our lunches all the time as kids.
Look how cute that is.
Okay, so there's your ladybug. Why don't you build your garden so you can add your veggies to your garden?
Oh,
for
wait,
the broccoli,
so
all you have to do is stick it in there like it's a little tree.
See, and I can remember, and my grandma, till the day she died, always said, I remember you always saying you love broccoli because they're like little trees.
Yep, they look like little trees. So you're building a little garden veggie forest, if you will.
I want this to be like the Sherwood
Forest. A really big forest, a thick forest.
This is so fun.
So see, kids could be completely involved in this. Making lunches doesn't have to be a chore or challenge. It could be something fun where everybody's involved. And honestly, how long did that take us?
Not long.
Not long. If we had,
we're not cooking anything.
Yeah,
so.
We're not. You're not preparing anything. And again, we're using all the different food groups to create a great lunch. So then on your side, you know, you can pair your fruit on the side. You could pack a single serve milk or yogurt or something for an additional dairy source. But again, these are easy, simple, fast things that don't take long that kids could be involved in at home.
Right. A lot of people are commenting. Michelle says, great idea, thanks.
Well, you're welcome. And there's so many good ideas online right now. We have some articles too, and I know that I sent you guys the link if you want to share, but different quick lunch bento box ideas for kids. And again, since these containers are so easy.
Is that what the box is
called, the bento box? Yep, so all you have to do, once you get
everything
in there, the lids all stack on, and then that's the ice pack, and it just locks into the center of the kit. So what you do is you put it on there, and then you stack your other two.
It's like Legos, too.
And then it fits nicely into your lunchbox, into your backpack, whatever it might be, and it stays cool because the ice box is in the middle, and it's easy peasy.
Yeah.
I was just thinking, I don't remember how we kept our lunches cold.
I feel like we always had to pack, like, a frozen juice box or a frozen yogurt or something else, like a water bottle that was ice, and then it had to melt by lunch.
Yeah, because there wasn't, like, a communal fridge or anything.
No, everything was just, you had to have a little ice pack.
You had to have a little baby ice pack.
And
you can also make sandwiches in lots of other fun things, or cut out, you know, whatever size cookie cutters, or if you want to theme their lunch boxes, there's individual cookie cutters. You know, you can do a princess theme and do crowns and castles, and you can build different fun ideas. It doesn't have
Jody
to be as labor intensive as that.
Jody says,
what do you do when your kids don't eat fruits and vegetables?
Shove them down their throat.
One of the best ways to introduce them is to, when you're shopping, allow them to come with you and say, okay, we're going to pick out one thing together from this aisle. What looks good to you? And start in produce and walk them through and let them point at the fruit or the vegetable that they're willing to try. And honestly, children do tend to love dips. And now we do say to portion control that, but there's been so many studies out there that showcase that individuals, children and adults, eat about 80% more vegetables if we allow them to dip it in something.
That's true.
So at the end of the day, if you can introduce them to that, at the end of the day, they probably will start eating more fruits and vegetables if they're allowed. There's dessert hummus they can dip.
Yeah.
Apple slices and snickerdoodle hummus. I know I brought that to you guys like a year ago. You got to try the dessert hummus.
And if you're using, if they're into hummus, that's fine.
Well, and again, I mean, kids, if they can touch and feel, they're very sensory. They like to learn. They like to play with their food. This is an okay way to play with your food and build something out of it, and then get them excited about, this is what's packed in your lunch today. This is what you're going to get to eat.
You get to eat a ladybug.
You can also do it in a way where you're preparing, you know, everything together as a family, and you can say, well, this is your three options. Which one
do you want?
Will you like? So again, giving them options, allowing them to be involved in the process, I think is a really good way. Smoothies and shakes, honestly, are another very easy way to hide it. And if you're on a time crunch in the morning and you wanted to make little smoothie freezer packs, so take on Sunday and put your strawberries and your blueberries and your spinach in a bag and throw it in the blender in the morning and have your kids enjoy it that way. Then it's already cold and ready to go out the door. And those are just some things, again, it comes down to a lot of preparation on our end, which is always something, but if you prioritize it, it becomes a very easy habit to get into.
All right, so moving on to after school snack, banana sushi roll. Sven was like, what on earth is banana sushi? Yeah, so kids come home, they're starving off the school bus, and they want something fun and easy.
Yeah, and this is one of those things, again, where for the most part, they can do it on their own. They would just probably need your assistance in cutting it up into the slices.
That's so fancy,
no
too.
No cooking involved.
So how do we start with that?
No cooking. So why don't you guys grab tortillas today? So I always start with a whole grain tortilla
base. I'll let you take
yourself a quesadilla.
And so today we're using Frascato's tortillas. They're local out of Eagan, Minnesota, so I do like to support local companies. And this is a nice soft whole grain tortilla. You want whole grain tortillas that are going to be soft and not break when you roll it up.
Yes,
and this is one
feels
that
soft.
Is soft and ready to go. Now you're going to spread your sunflower butter on.
Sunflower butter?
Yes.
With a spoon or with the knife?
You can use whatever you feel.
That's thick.
Sunflower butter. What's all in here?
Sunflower butter is free of the top 8 major allergens. So especially for kids that are going to school and maybe their school doesn't allow them to bring nut butters, this could also be something that could be packed in your lunch. As in opposed to traditional peanut butter sandwiches that you bring.
Peanut butter?
Sometimes they have a peanut-free table or section that the students have to eat it. Sometimes they ask
when
that you not
kid,
pack peanut butter.
Those allergies.
And so you just need to know your school lunchroom or guidelines.
Right.
Again, for the most part, it's just one of those kind of courtesy things that you can do to make it safer for everybody at school and make it safer for the teachers and the children that are enjoying lunch in the same room as you.
That looks good. Oh my gosh.
It's like a Frisbee over here. What are you doing?
That would have been so great if it landed on your pants.
Stickier than peanut butter.
Yes.
Is it?
It's like, more pasty.
Now you gotta peel your banana.
Peel it.
Sven's a monkey today, guys. He's gotta peel the banana.
Oh, you peel it that way?
How do you do it?
That's how I peel it.
The other way. It's way easier.
Everything in Wisconsin's weird.
How do you?
That's how monkeys peel it. This way. It's way easier.
That way.
You're weird.
She is weird. No.
Now we should ask how Chris does it, because Canadians do weird things, too.
Okay, then lay it on one end of the tortilla.
Oh, so we're not cutting it up yet.
Nope, you're going to roll it first. So I would put it all the way towards the end.
Oh, I see.
You got to get a nice tight roll. So
add
roll
a little
it up.
Cheese in there.
If you wanted to, you could.
This is how they do it in Japan.
But this is curved, so.
Yep, you got to be a little artsy.
Oh, boy.
Can you handle it?
Here you go. Mm-hmm. I trust you. So, again, we're incorporating a whole grain, a protein source, and a fruit into this.
Voila.
Voila.
Now I cut.
Now you slice.
I want to cut something.
Oh, you're okay.
Your sound effects are really winning us over today, Sven.
Sven's never grown up.
Nope.
This is why all kids, big and small, would love to make this at home. So these are one of those things where, honestly, you probably have tortillas left over from taco night.
Oh, yeah.
Bananas are a very common lunch-packed item and very, you know, friendly for children,
tasty.
Very easy.
And you also got them while they're more green than brown because kids don't like them when they're brown.
Then you can make banana bread.
Yep. Yes, then you can always freeze them.
Then you trick
them. Again, you could use frozen bananas in your smoothies in the morning. You could use them in...
What do you do with the end pieces?
Eat them.
Okay.
Enjoy them. So then what you can do
I've never had sunflower butter.
It's really good.
Good? I'm going to try one of yours.
You can add your topping on like they would in a sushi restaurant. So you could cut up strawberries. You could add on top a halved raspberry or blackberry.
I just drizzled more sunflower butter on top.
So I put a little bit in the microwave.
I was just saying, so that's what you did here.
That's what I did here is I microwaved it for about 30 seconds. And then I got it to where it was at a drizzling consistency. And then I just added it on top.
That's really good.
Because immediately when I saw that and I was using this, I'm like, this is really thick.
Nope, you do have to microwave it a little bit, just like you probably would any natural peanut butter. And again, if you don't, you know, have that at home or it's not necessary for you to use because of allergy purposes, you can use almond butter, peanut butter, cashew butter, whatever you would like. But it's a hearty filling snack that should help satisfy them and tide them over until dinner time. Or again, too, if they're in activities after school, this is something that could be packed in a little airtight container, wrap it up, and they can eat that on the way to their sports activity. They can eat that afterwards. Yep, you want something that's gonna have some carbohydrates and some protein in there to fuel them up. So you're getting that fruit and whole grain carbohydrate, and then you're getting your protein source.
Awesome. All right, we have the recipes posted. Melissa Jaeger from Hyvee Savage. Thank you so much.
This is good.
Look at you going to town.
I think I'm going to serve this at my next adult party.
There you go.
What do we make next? Can we do some sort of tailgating football healthy option?
Certainly. Yeah, let's do that.
All right, that'll be good.
That's always fun.
It's the season.
It is the season. I know. Everybody's getting so excited and ready to go. And I did want to say, too, take a look at some of the options that are over there in the front corner. If your kids are really picky, Kind released fruit bites that are made entirely of fruit, no sugar added. So they're like a gummy, but they're just whole fruits. And so that could be one serving of fruit is one package of that. So again, if like she commented, if your child is picky and not eating fruits or vegetables, they might eat fruit gummies or fruit bars or something along those lines. So that way you're getting some different options
in there.
Yeah.
And that popcorn brand.
Whole grain. Another
Angie's. It's good for adults too.
It is. And it's literally just popcorn, sunflower oil, and sea salt. So it's nothing that you have to add anything to, and it's a single serve container.
Is it
vegan? Well, she was calling my name when she's like, oh, the picky kid who won't eat any fruits and vegetables. I have one of those.
Perfect. Mm-hmm. Yes, Kind Fruit Bites are an awesome solution. They come in a couple different flavors, and a single package is a serving of fruit.
How much is this?
I don't know off the top of my head. I'm sorry. I feel like I should be on the Prices Right. Like, guess how much this grocery item
she'll
is.
Send you plus
for $1 million.
Awesome. All right.
Perfect.
Thank you, Melissa.
Thank you. Have a good day, everybody.
Thanks for being a guest visitor.
If you have more lunchbox ideas, you can always come visit us in the store. We have dietitians at each location that can help you pack the healthiest lunch for your child.
Awesome stuff. All right. Happy Thursday. We'll see you next week on Care in the Kitchen.